I was going to start off with TRNSMT because I was down there and I saw your performance a few weeks ago now. And it really struck me because I remember seeing you there a couple of years back too. But this time, you know, you're on a much bigger stage. You've got this huge crowd, you know, singing your words back to you. How do you feel you've grown as a band between those two performances? And what other instances feel like good indicators of your growth as both a band and also just as songwriters and artists?
I feel like number one, the main thing is confidence as a band and comfort. Like we're comfortable on stage. Like I think like we feel like very confident, like coming back after the pandemic, these shows, I felt like so much more confident, I think having time to realize that how lucky we are. And as you say, with fans seeing stuff back, it's like, just fucking like be that band, you know? Yeah, it's kind of confident. And I think like having this lockdown, writing this new album, being better, I feel like we're better as songwriters, you know, coming back knowing we've got something that we're really proud of and that we're going to back. Coming into these shows and from TRNSMT, playing sick at TRNSMT, being confident about that. Yeah, I think it's confidence. And I think you can see it if you look at the BBC things, like, I don't know, like, I don't think I knew what I was doing when we played TRNSMT first time or whatever. Do you know what I mean? Like, I just feel like really, I think we all feel like really like grounded in our performance and like very connected. I feel way more connected in the performance. Yeah.
Do you see that reflected in the music too, in your own writing?
Yeah, I think I do. Lyrically, this new album, I mean, we really found our, you know, we're finding our feet on the first album, but just this new album coming through, I think writing wise, like lyrically, it's so much more direct. Like Sick is very direct, you know, and this whole new album, you can really like feel like who we are and who I am in the lyrics and the sound of it. Yeah, it really feels like we've got better and it feels really true as well. I don't feel like I've got to like pretend to be someone else or channel something else on stage. Like I'm just keeping it real, I think, you know.
You've spoken in the past too about how, you know, you want to build a world with your music. How is approaching that different now when you've already laid down, you know, such a complete statement with the debut record?
How's that different now? I think it's like keeping on it and just staying true and doing what excites you. It's just a continuing thing. And it's basically like keeping up a level of truth and a level of consistency to it and just keeping real with who we are. And it's just exciting that people are already buying into that, you know, with the debut album. Just seeing that in these shows and in everything we've done since, like we didn't play for a year and a half. And that people get it, people are connecting with it. That's fucking great. And, you know, I feel we know our fans and they know us and just staying true to that.
Are there any, you know, like practices or rituals that you have to put in place to keep in touch with who you are and keep in touch with yourself?
Sometimes you can get kind of lost. I don't know. If there are, I haven't found them yet. Yeah, so maybe. But I think the last few weeks have just been so rushing around. Like, and today I was just like, what the fuck's going on? Like just before I got on this here. And it's just like, what? Yeah, you do constantly question, like in art and like with a music video, like, is this right? Is this like, is this real? Like, you know, so I don't know. We'll see.
You mentioned how direct, you know, Sick is as a song, one of your most direct tracks that you ever put out to date. And it's interesting to me because a lot of your songs, you know, they're quite affectionate, although some of them may have a bite to them. This one, it's more like there's a frustration to it and you're writing against something. How does that change things throughout the process when you're writing against something and there's a slightly different atmosphere and intent with the song?
I'd say it added an energy like this. I feel like there's an added energy. We had that great energy on the first album and we weren't just going to keep peddling. I think it added an energy and an importance and why there's just as much fucking bite in a different way to this new album than the last one. And it was exciting writing lyrics and about things that I hadn't before. I think about mortality in this album. Six about kind of growing up, but also just focusing in on like a time when I was fucking sick of everything. Yeah, I think it just felt real. Yeah, I think it just like gave a renewed energy. Like, and I that was one of those songs when I realized, oh, right, there's a purpose to this album, you know? Just as there was with the first one, there's a different purpose to this one.
How many songs did you have to write before you got to a point where the purpose started to reveal itself for the record?
I'd say not that many. I feel like it was pretty early on that there was like that opportunity. First part of lockdown, I don't think any of us wrote anything. I didn't write anything. And it was good. There was like 2 months, just left it and then got back in. I felt a freedom that I wasn't writing a debut album anymore. I wasn't tied to the first song I wrote. I wasn't tied to Call Me Out and Too Much Fun. Not that that made the album. Do you know what I mean? I wasn't tied to like a debut vibe. I could just be fully real.
But then there are also different pressures that come around with writing the second album, particularly when the first one's been a success.
Yeah, I guess so. And luckily, I don't think we felt that, because I feel like I just got into a stride and I felt super confident, you know. And I feel like pretty lucky with that, with this second album. There was none of that sort of like, I think this is, oh my God, we've got to like do something that's good. Because I think early on, I knew that there were songs that were like solid, really good, you know. And it was like, great, this is a great starting point. Like some of those songs didn't make it on the album. But like, I feel like we were already like, this is totally good enough, you know, and I feel like we just got into a stride with how we were making music, and luckily we didn't have to worry too much about that second album problem.
I always find it funny how some of the most important songs don't often make it onto the record too, like the ones that kind of kickstart it then kind of get left in the dust a little bit once you're in that flow.
Yeah, there's definitely a couple of those that might come out or whatever, but you know, it just there was some certain songs, like just themes I was writing around, which was like, who am I? Just mortality, the idea of like fucking choosing to stay alive instead of fucking, do you know what I mean? It's like, I've got fucking stay alive, or I don't know.
That like, maybe also leads into the directness and the kind of bite to it, to this element of survival.
Yeah, exactly. I think it matches the album and it, yeah. And there's a sort of theme right throughout that. There's a lot of that kind of writing, which starts in kind of sick, which is very sort of, being like, right, I'm going to change my life a little bit. And and then there's just another theme throughout the album, this sort of affectionate thing that's still like, I'm quite an affectionate guy or whatever, but it's just a breakdown of one relationship, which also runs throughout the album because it was written in such a short period of time.
Also runs nicely in parallel to the theme of mortality, I imagine, the idea of this thing breaking down.
Exactly, yeah. Like, you know, a whole arc of a relationship. Yeah.
It's interesting because, you know, we're talking about how you're thinking about these deeper things and they're very much influencing your music. When you're having those conversations with yourself about mortality and such like on a regular basis, how does that impact your life? Not even within the music, just outside of it in your day to day.
I think it makes me feel very grateful. Like also like putting that debut album out, I was super grateful for our fans, everyone that was connecting to it. I got it like in lockdown. Like, I was just so, there was clearly like, you know, the whole mortality issue of like the world was thinking about that because of the pandemic. But then there was also like, I felt really grateful, I think. And there's a lot of joy, and I think there's a lot, like the first album, I wasn't like, there's no time, like there's a few songs on this where it's like, it's serious. I'm keeping it real and like, you know, talking about places I've been, you know, mentally or whatever. But it's actually like, I'm super just grateful to be alive and living the life I'm living. You know, there's a couple of songs like that, and one of the singles touches on that.
Do you think you would have gained that perspective at the same speed had COVID not happened?
Yeah, maybe not, because I'd say towards, until COVID, we were going at such a rate and so busy. It was almost like, I mean, that's what being in a band is all about, is just doing it all. But like, I felt like it was kind of like coming off the rails, you know, and I didn't know what was up and what was down. And I think, yeah, the chance to stop like gave that sort of renewal, because it was pretty, it just felt crazy up until that point with our touring and everything.
It's interesting that we've touched upon the idea to know that you were asking a lot of questions with this record. What answers did you gain through creating it? What did you learn from making this album on a personal level?
I'd say the one main thing is just like great being like enjoying, like I enjoy myself so much more, like fucking like loving being in the band, loving like having fans, like this opportunity that we've got to go out and tour. I've never looked forward to it more. Yeah. And just like, I don't know, man, I'd say that's the main thing. It's just like feeling like hopeful and like, yeah, just pretty grateful at the moment. Yeah.
Is that partly what feeds into what we started this conversation with, and the idea that you've kind of grown on stage and that you're a lot more confident?
Probably, maybe, yeah. I think we've always enjoyed gigging, but like, yeah, I just feel like we know what we are, and I'd say it's all linked, yeah.
When would you say that you feel most connected to your own music?
When do I feel most connected to my own music? I'd say when performing it, when playing it, yeah. Just like right there with the people that performing it in front of people that it was intended to be written to hear, you know, like at our shows. Yeah.
Do you remember the last encounter that you had with someone who's connected with your music that kind of affected you in quite a deep way or had an impact on you in some sense?
A few people doing the these shows we've just done, festivals, like quite a few people will come up, a festival being like that, like really helped me through lockdown or a breakup or something. Do you know what I mean? So like there were a few moments on this run of festivals that and shows that people have said that. Yeah, I do. Yeah.
What was the most cathartic moment making this record for you, do you think?
I think when it was all coming together and we'd nearly finished it and like just knowing that like it was exciting and we had all this to show and that it had all been put down, all like, you know, I think that like towards the end of finishing the recording process.
You start to see all the various threads kind of line up, like what we're talking about.
Yeah, and it was like, I think like this is exciting that we can put this out and share this with our fans and people. And it's great that we can, people are going to hear this and this is the way we want the messages to come across and stuff. Yeah.
When you started writing for this album, were you very conscious that you were writing for your second record, or do you just start creating in a space that isn't really tied to anything?
Yeah, I guess kind of for a second record, but also like I felt like the themes like homesick, of like feeling like wanting to belong somewhere or belonging somewhere. Like homesick is like, it means you belong somewhere, you know, and I belong to, you know, wanting like a guy that's wanted to belong, have an identity and like belong to a relationship I used to have or belong to, you know, where I grew up and mistakes I've made and fucking lifestyle choices and things like that.
I mean, you have that line about not having any regrets now and you kind of just look back on it as feeling young.
Yeah, I think, yeah, you got to like just be like, yeah, just try and like just get rid of it. Don't like hold yourself down with how you've been. Just try and be like better. I think, you know, yeah, otherwise like just try not to get in your own head about things. Exactly that. Just like let go and just put it all down into an album.
That sense of belonging that you mentioned, where do you feel most at home in the world? Where do you get that sense of belonging most in your life?
I think writing music, you know, and being in this band. Yeah, basically.
That sounds like it would be something that would be quite beneficial to mental health, because it's not reliant upon anything. It's not tied to a particular place or particular person. It's this universal thing that you can go to at any time.
Yeah, I think that's a real, like, that's why I feel it's very lucky to be, have this position, this point. And, you know, I love my friends and family and I've got that as well. So, but yeah, no, it is great to have like that. Yeah, I think that's when I'm happiest, is making music. Yeah.